This is not what I expected when I said it was a rough day. I just got some pretty bad news.
Perfect.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to Life of Burch. This one is a little bit different for you because I'm not on a motorcycle right now. I've been sick for the past, 4 days, honestly, and today's the first day that I woke up feeling like a human again. And I figured it would be cool to do a quick little, day in the life. I'm starting a little bit late. It's, 3:40 in the afternoon. But I'm getting some Life of Burch merch worked on, so I figured it'd be cool to take you guys along for the ride. I watch Adam LZ, and I like the stuff that he does with his little, I don't know, day in the life type stuff. So I figured it'd be cool to do for you guys also. And I'm literally just filming on my iPhone. So we'll see how it goes. That's what he uses sometimes also, instead of carrying around the big camera. So I'm going to give it a shot. And if it works, then great. And all the people who are saying they want to start a channel or whatever, but they don't have the resources, I'm literally using my 3-year-old iPhone. But earlier in the day, I hopped on Fiverr.com, which is one of those freelance websites where you can pay people $5 to do something for you. So I paid this guy $5 and he did a digitized image of the Life of Burch logo so that it could be embroidered. There's a certain file it needs to be where they actually have to map the stitching. So I had him do that, and I'm headed to the mall right now to actually get the first Life of Burch snapback embroidered. It's gonna be similar to this one, the ride clutch or whatever, but obviously it's gonna be the Life of Burch logo, and we're gonna see how that turns out. I paid him $5 and after fees and everything. Oh, there's a cop crossing the parking lot. Let me not roll up on him recording on my phone while I'm driving. But so we're gonna go to the mall and get the first Life of Burch snapback, see what it looks like, see if the embroidery works, and see if it's something that I want to start selling to you guys. This is a terrible angle. Unreal. But first we're stopping at Rise Up because coffee. I feel great. I feel wide awake, but you can never have too much coffee. So we're going to grab some coffee and then head to the mall and see how this embroidery thing turns out. All right, secured the bag. Oh my Lanta, that is so good. It's not on the menu, but when you come to Rise Up, I don't know if they'll like me giving out all their trade secrets, but cold brew with almond milk and a cinnamon toast crunch flavor is the way to go. Straight up fire. I used to just, dude, I gotta get used to holding this thing straight. Oh man, gotta clear my throat. Obviously I'm not 100% better. I used to just get a cold brew with cream and vanilla flavoring, but the cinnamon toast crunch flavor is the way to go. Super good. I'm gonna get caffeinated and then we're headed to the mall now to see how the snapbacks turn out. So fingers crossed. So I guess on the way to the mall, it's only 2 minutes away, but I'll give you guys a quick update on the bikes since that's why the majority of you guys are here. First update I guess I'll do on the Grom. As you guys know, I've been saying I'm gonna get it inspected forever and it still is not inspected. I've just been slacking off with that. As bad as it is, I've still been riding it, but only locally. Not that you can take a Grom much further than locally without hating your life. But anyway, hoping to get that inspected this week. I keep saying that, but hopefully actually having that happen. In the last little Grom Sunday Funday video that I did, I told you guys all about the stuff that I had to do to get it ready to pass inspection, like the tag lights and the reflectors and all that kind of good stuff. So hopefully that should be all that it needs. Dude, I'm stuttering, having a stroke. So yeah, hopefully that should be all that it needs and then we'll be good to go. But when I take it in, we'll find out. The issue is that it's a Grom, so I can't obviously ride it super far. And the Pete's Cycle, so I got my Rebel from Pete's Cycle, I'm sure you guys remember. And that one is in Baltimore. It's about a 45-50 minute drive away from me. Obviously, I don't want to be doing that on a Grom because it's all highway, so it ended up taking me way longer on the Grom. But they do have a Pete's Cycle in Severna Park that's literally 8 minutes from my house. The issue is that they're not a Honda authorized dealer, so they won't even work on Hondas. So when I talked to them previously about one of my old Rebels and getting it inspected there, they were like, yeah, we can inspect it, but if it needs any work done, we're gonna have to inspect it, not pass it, and then you'll have to come pick it up and take it somewhere else to get the work done or do the work yourself and then bring it back to have it checked out again. And obviously that is not ideal. So I'm gonna keep my fingers crossed that it is 100% ready for inspection so I can just take it there tomorrow and not have to worry about getting anything fixed on it or anything like that, and just being good to go. So, and update on the Rebel, everything is still good to go with that. I haven't gotten any new parts to put on it yet, just because aftermarket parts are still impossible to find. Nina and I have gone on it, I guess, 2 times total now, and she loves it, but the main thing that she said is that it's just not super comfortable as far as the seat goes, and we've also determined that a sissy bar would help lock her in. So the plan is that I'm either going to have the rear passenger seat recovered with more padding and also like a non-slip cover so that she's not sliding around, or find another seat that I can put on there. Obviously it would probably end up being easier to just have the stock seat recovered, but the amount of money it'll cost, it might just be worth getting something else. I don't know. So yeah, with that said, go check out my Patreon, patreon.com/lifeofburch, and support the channel. That way you get bonus content, exclusive merch. The hats, if they end up working out, will be going to Patreon members only at first anyway. And yeah, that money helps me do cool stuff for the channel and hopefully do cool things like getting a seat made. This flash drive has the files on it for getting the hat made, so hopefully I have the right files. It's the same ones I used before for my real estate hats that I made. So anyway, I'm in public and I feel like a douchebag walking around filming myself talking like a typical YouTuber, so I will check back in after we get the hat situation sorted out.
1 hour later.
Man, tough day to be a YouTuber. That was a complete strikeout all across the board. So I went to the place that I went to last time, and apparently they downsized from a full store to just one of those little like stands in the middle. It's bright as hell out here. It's like, what is it, in the 90s? This is why I'm not riding right now. But yeah, they downsized from like a full-size store to just one of the little stands in the middle. And I'm like, yo, do you have any snapbacks? I want to get one embroidered. I literally called you earlier to see what the maximum size was for a file. He's like, no snapbacks. I'm like, what? He's like, well, we have one, but it's like this ugly dark green color on display. And I'm like, yeah, I don't want an ugly dark green color. So then I went to Lids, the hat store Lids, and they were like, nah, we can't do it. Like, you can only do that through lids.com and you have to get the image digitized. And I was like, I already have it digitized. I just do it for me. And he's like, nah, we can't do that here. I guess they can only do like, you know, typical fonts or whatever. So I'm like, okay, that sucks. But then they have a custom ink that's in the mall that does embroidery and design and stuff like that. I go there and they're freaking closed. Like, what the heck? And people wonder why retail is dying, because, oh my gosh, dude, dropping the freaking flash drive. Anyway, you wonder why retail is dying, and it's because I go to one of the biggest malls in the area and everything is closed, or they don't have what I want. And I can just go online and Jeff Bezos will print me one within 5 seconds. So yeah, tough day to be a YouTuber. I also didn't mention that while I was in the mall, I tried looking up embroidery in Annapolis, and there's not enough signal in the mall to look it up, and their Wi-Fi wasn't working. So I think it's all part of a plot against me, but I'm gonna Google if there's any embroidery shops not at the mall and give that a try. Not the best first day trying to do a day in the life video, but we'll see. Okay, update. This is not what I expected when I said it was a rough day. I just got some pretty bad news. So, Nina, so I was just, let me backtrack a little bit. So I was just parked trying to get signal to Google the embroidery place, and Nina calls me, and I'm like, that's weird. She's supposed to be working. Long story short, she's like, hey, I had direct contact with somebody who has COVID at work. I just found out. So I'm being sent home and I have to get tested. And I'm like, bruh, that could explain a lot. Like I said, I was just sick for the past 4 days. So this is this is not good. This is not the update I wanted. Needless to say, I'm going home until I can go tomorrow so we can figure out if we actually do have it. So yeah, that cuts off the Life of Burch hat journey, because obviously if I'm not sure if I have it, I'm not gonna keep going in stores. So this sucks. Update on the situation. They didn't have at-home tests, so we're getting actual tests done. What's up, Nina? Life is going great.
Coffee? That's not even funny anymore.
How deep does it have to go?
So she said.
Make sure that there's still out the liquid.
What's that?
Make sure that there's still out the
liquid. Oh, I didn't realize there was liquid in there. Don't spill out the liquid. No, she said make sure not to. All right, here it goes.
Is it both or just one?
Both. Deeper than that.
My nose is tiny. That's literally the bridge of my nose. That hurts.
Oh shit, I coughed. All right, thank you. Have a good one. All right, we're done. How'd it go?
2 out of 10 stars.
2 out of 10 stars. Not great. I have no idea if we'll have the results before this video posts, but if I don't have the results, I'll put it in the comments to let you guys know if I'm dying or not. See you guys on the next video.